That's what the bay like. Call me Buffy cause that's what I slay like. These bitches I sun them like it's daylight. These niggas wanna know what it tastes like. What it tastes like, yo, what it tastes like, yo. They wanna know what it tastes like, yo. All this ice, it just tastes like snow. Get kimonos and let's fly to Tokyo. Pitsy, pitsy, please, baby, won't you pop this for me?
Hey y'all, welcome back to my welcome to my channel. If you are new, and if not, welcome back. I know the crazy now, but don't worry, we're gonna fix that. Let's get started with the video. So the first thing I do is put my LA Pro Concealer in the shade Toffee on my eyelids as my base, and then I blend it in. Before I really start, I do check for boogers just to make sure, because we can't be walking around with a pretty face and boogers in your nose. Next, I go in with my shade powder foundation, and then I just set my concealer. After I set with my foundation powder, I like to go in with my setting powder just to make sure that it sets and it doesn't crease, because concealer loves to crease. So I seen this little hack, I think on TikTok, which was like, if you put setting powder on your face before you apply foundation, your makeup will be smooth and bead and all that. But if you have oily skin, I wouldn't recommend do this because it makes it more oily. So what's the point? Before you come for me, this foundation that I use is like yellow undertones, so I know it looks orange, but don't worry, after a while it sets in and you don't look like a Oompa Loompa.
How fly is he?
So we just blend. Then I go in and wet my brush, my foundation brush. I see as though my makeup like looks better when I use a foundation brush and a beauty blender instead of just using a beauty blender. So yeah, I'd recommend doing that. So now I'm just going in with a second coat of foundation because I apply my first coat in a thin layer because I don't like the cakey look. So yeah, I add a second layer just to make sure that it's coverage. After I apply foundation, I go in with my flat eyeshadow brush and I like to usually blend out the little spots that I missed or the patches or whatever it looks like. The concealer I'm using to highlight is the same concealer that I use for my eyebrows. I know a lot of people use different shades, but I don't. So yeah, that's how I do it. If you don't do it that way, then good for you, but this is how I do it. Oh my gosh, this is why my videos just be so long, and this is why it takes me so long to do my makeup, because I'm always dancing or doing something. So now I just blend out that concealer with my beauty blender. So just tap, 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 tap. Make sure that blend in, because if you don't, you could like see the difference between your foundation and your highlight. And it's just that's a no. Trust me, I've been there before. It's a no. That's just how you could get flashback, and we don't want that. Next, I apply my setting powder again on the places that I highlight, and I do not wipe it off until I apply contour. For contour, I use the LA Girl Pro. I don't remember the shade, but I use one of the darker shades as contour for myself, and I'm still learning, so I don't really use like setting stuff for my contour. So with the helpful videos on YouTube that I watch, that you should blend your contour going down and not like, yeah, I can't explain it, but you should just go down. They say go down, so go down. And after I apply my contour, I would go straight into setting it so that it outlines. I just drag the setting powder along the line. I know you guys can't see it, but I could see it. You'll see it like when I turn to the front, but not to the side. As you can see, I kind of did something right. It kind of looks like, you know, that little chiseled jawline. Kind of, sort of. So yeah, I guess I'm doing something right. After I apply the setting powder to my contour, I blend in the contour on my nose because I don't set it. So I might as well blend it in one time. And then after I blend in the contour on my nose, I would go in and wipe off the setting powder on the places where I highlight. Next, I go in with my setting spray and I just spray it all over my face. Like, that's some religious water, baby. I spray it because I want to make sure that it sets, and when I go outside, even though I'm not going outside, that it doesn't get sweaty because I already have oily skin. You can't be looking oily times too. So now I go in with my small brush and I just blend in the places that I could still see aren't blended. Now I apply highlighter. I apply it on my brow bone, on my nose, and sometimes I apply it like above my lip just to give it a little effect. I like to do that. If you don't want to do it, you don't have to. Now I outline my lip with this brown pencil before I apply any lip gloss to it. Next, I apply little black dots around my face just to make it more natural. I usually follow like the dots that I have on my face already. So yeah, that's how I do it. And I finish the rest, like apply my lashes and stuff off camera because I couldn't get it on camera, sis. I wasn't about to be struggling here. So I just did it off camera. This is what it looks like. This is the shirt that I made. If you guys saw the shirt with the pins in them, I tried. This is my first time making them. And I think it's kind of cute. Let me know if you guys tried this or if you guys have tried this.
It's the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed me getting ready to basically take pictures and do nothing. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And turn on post notifications to be notified when I post. See you guys in my next video.